Señores, se llegó el día. Ahí va la flaca con su sorpresota. Para las merquitas. ¿Dónde va a servir?
¿Did you say in Vegas?
No, dije para las merquitas, pero no sé para dónde dijimos que iba a ser.
Oh, Newport.
Oh, para Newport, California. Saludos al pinche doctor. ¿Cómo es Tejeda?
Tanejas.
Pinche doctor, te va a bajar como nueva. Hija de la chingada. Ay, nos estamos viendo ahorita en el pinche caminito. Ahí con la flaca en vivo. Mira con su pinche maletilla fea. Ahí nos estamos viendo, raza. Este video va a ir para el meritito YouTube. ¿Qué onda, raza? Aquí andamos en el aeropuerto esperando a que podamos abordar el avión con la futura Kim Kardashian. Aquí esperando, mira. Ya lista, un poco nerviosa. Ahí lo sigo informando, nos vemos más tarde. Saludos pa'l Canelas. Ah, cabrón, soy yo, ¿verdad? ¿Qué onda, raza? Aquí andamos esperando por el avión a que salga, mira. Ya listos para abordar, faltan como 40 minutitos para que nos dejen subir a los asientos. Aquí andamos con la futura Kim Kardashian. Mírala, ya lista. Yo voy a asegurar mi pinche autógrafo. Ahí si quieren, mándenme mensaje para ponerlos en la lista. Porque ya después cuando vaya agarrando fama ya no va a querer firmar. Así que ahí nomás saquen para el Dutch y les hago el paro. Vamos a San Francisco, señora. ¿Y de aquí para dónde? Para mi rancho. De aquí vamos para Los Ángeles. Nos tocó hacer escala. Papi Muñeño. ¿Qué onda, raza? Era y vamos llegando al lugar donde hacen las buchonas. Aquí es donde las buchonas se hacen, señores. Donde la 69 se hizo ahí las pinches pechugonas que se le ven ahí en los videos.
Son las 69. Son la cabrona. Que salió de Riverside.
Esa es así.
I'm telling you to shut up.
You shut up. Me tengo que encontrar dónde está el doctor Sasso que me va a arreglar a mi vieja. A ver, ¿qué te sientes? ¿Qué sientes? Dile aquí en mi público, ¿qué sientes?
Nothing.
¿No sientes nervios?
Yes.
Ah, eso no te puse. Dice, siento nervios. Así. Mira, joder, su chingada madre, ese doctor es el que me la va a dejar como nueva. Es como ponerle de nuevo defensas a tu carro. Inviértanle, inviértanle, porque está cabrón. Luego se deja.
¿Lo parte?
Un poco.
A ver. ¿Está bien?
Está bien, bueno.
¿Ya?
Aquí venimos ya nomás al Bicycle Casino y Hotel. ¿Dónde dice? A ver, ¿para dónde me parqueo? Porque no sabo.
El muchacho ya ha ganado varios dólares allá en la bolsa. Ahora ya tiene dinero para comprar lo que le gusta. Ay, ay, ay. Puro rorro.
Oh my
puro
god. Rorro,
puro canela.
You're fucking crazy.
Thank you.
gave us front row. And Juan doesn't want to go on. He was trying to switch rows. Because he's too scared to get on.
And here we go!
Mi gente, era aquí, son las 5:30 de la mañana y ya vamos en camino a las oficinas de instalaciones del doctor. Sepa la madre cómo se llama, pero del doctor, ahí vamos. Ahí va la futura persona. Y mira. Vamos a ir tempranito para que la listen. Ando todo desvelado, señores. ¿Cómo te sientes? ¿Estás nerviosa, mi amor? No te preocupes. ¿No es lo que querías? Órale. Vamos a ir. Ahorita apenas vamos saliendo del hotel. Quedan como 15 minutos, está de lejos. 10, 15 minutos. Bueno, señores, aquí me retiro. Después les grabo otro videito chiquito ahí para que vayan viendo el proceso.
Espérate, pues, verga. Señores, llegamos al lugar de operaciones.
Ay, güey, se ve bien. Curioso. Okay. Vamos llegando, miren, allí es. Vamos a ver que todo salga bien. A los mantendremos informados sobre todo el proceso. Miren. Bueno, un cambio fuera.
Esa chichona. Volte para acá. Una sonrisa. Colgate. No, lo que no, verga, quería.
So, it's day one and I actually feel pretty good. I don't have too much pain. It only hurts like when I walk. I feel a little bit out of breath because I have pressure because of the implants, but the medicine actually helps a lot, and I feel a lot better than when I actually got out. In the morning, I was in a lot of pain when I woke up from surgery, but it's not that bad right now. I'm really swollen still, and I still do have pain. I do have to sleep kind of elevated. I can't sleep straight, but so far, so good. Juan has been taking care of me pretty good, so that also helps make me feel a little bit better, because he gives me all the medicine that I need. It's been actually making me really sleepy. I've been in and out of sleep because it's pretty strong, but I feel like it's only going to be like this for just maybe the first and second day. I've heard are the worst, because you're just so sore more than anything, and your body's just getting used to foreign object being in your body, but it's not that bad, thankfully. But this is day one of my surgery. So Joel went to the store to get me a heating pad for my back. It's weird because my hands actually hurt. Like, they don't hurt. Like, it's not my hands. It's my arms. Like, my arms hurt for some reason. More than my back right now. So, he went to the store to get me a heating pad so that I can put in the areas that hurt. So that it helps a little bit. And hopefully it does. It's not like a lot of pain, but it is just uncomfortable. So I went to the store to go get one of my other medications and a heating pad. I got in and out, and I can't eat that right now. It's fucking torture. Soon as I recover. What are you gonna do?
Tomorrow we're gonna go get hot dogs. Y como el doctor dijo, no cosas grasosas, I'll give you my pico de gallo. No me chingo los hot dogs. I'll give you extra pico de gallo.
So these are the type of implants. These are the profiles. This is the high profile, which is what I got. I think these ones are moderate profile. can see the difference right there. This one's more extended for when you have a bigger chest. This one is smaller, but a lot more rounder. You can see the difference.
Hi, so we're seeing a patient who just had a breast augmentation 2 days ago. She's an out-of-town patient. She flew in from Oregon. We had initially done her consultation online. She had sent her pictures, she had sent her information. We got back to her, we gave her a recommendation, and then she scheduled a surgery date. She came in 2 days before her surgery, and she came to the office to try her implants on, and we found a great size. So then, but the day after, or 2 days after she came in, she had a breast augmentation. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I saw her, we talked about her size, we talked about her shape. She met the anesthesiologist, and then we performed her procedure. Everything went very well. She's now 2 days out. Mm-hmm. We did saline implants. So we made two small incisions on the bottom of her breast, lifted up the muscle. So now she's 2 days out. She feels good. She's ready to fly back. And when she flies back, she's going to send us pictures every 2 weeks to show her progress. She has two little stitches on each side, which she'll have them removed either by like a doctor or a nurse. Mm-hmm. Or they're pretty, it's pretty simple to remove a stitch. You just pull and cut on the bottom. She's going to be wearing a sports bra for about 4 to 6 weeks after surgery. Mm-hmm. No pushing or pulling, no lifting anything. Tell your husband no cleaning or cooking for 1 year. No. That's a common question. So when can you drink is usually after you're done taking the antibiotics. So you had your surgery on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. So you'll be done so for 1 week, so after next Tuesday, so 7 days.
Okay. You're gonna start working out.
So you can start doing lower body, you can start doing cardio after a week, but nothing upper body, no heavy lifting, no pushing, no pulling. Okay. No planks, no push-ups, no pull-ups for 6 weeks.
And I use two bras, right?
To use two bras when you're working out. Use lots of cocoa butter, bio oils, cream. So all you out-of-town patients, it's very simple. And then if you have any questions or issues, you have the phone number to the on-call nurse, you have the clinic phone number, you have our email address, you have our Instagram, you have all these ways to get a hold of us.